So let's talk about Bollinger Bands. You see, Bollinger Bands are a very powerful indicator, but most traders are using it in the wrong way. So today I'm going to show you how to use them in the right way. Now, first of all, Bollinger Bands are a super simple concept because it's basically a simple moving average and two standard deviations. Let's jump on the charts and let me show you exactly what it looks like. If you're bringing up the Bollinger Bands on your charting software, no matter what you're using, the software that I'm using here is TradingView, but you can use thinkorswim, TradeStation, finance.yahoo.com charts, free charts, whatever it will be, then you will see that there's a center line, which is a moving average, and you see a standard deviation above the moving average and below. Now, Bollinger Bands come with three settings. So let's take a look at the three settings here. First of all, the length. And the standard length here is either 20 or 21 days. So it doesn't really matter what you choose. Whatever your charting software suggests is a good starting point here. And then it also asks about how many standard deviations. And again, the default here is two. So let's start with two standard deviations. Now, most people, this is where I'm telling you, they're using it in the wrong way because they're using it as a so-called trend fading system. What does it mean? Well, let me show you an example. Let's go to IBM because we used IBM in our previous video about support and resistance. And if you would like to see the video, we'll post the link in the description so that you don't miss it. So here you see IBM has been going sideways for most of the time. We applied the Bollinger Bands here, and this is how many people use the Bollinger Bands. You might notice that most of the time prices are within the Bollinger Bands. Depending on the settings, so for example, the settings that I told you here means that 98% of the closing prices are within the Bollinger Bands. So this is why some people say as soon as prices move outside Bollinger Bands, as they do here on the left side of the screen, you start buying because it is very likely that they're going back inside the Bollinger Bands. Now, then they also say if Bollinger Bands close outside the upper band, this is when you would be selling because it is very likely that now the Bollinger Bands go back inside the bands. And you see, yes, in a sideways market, this is a viable strategy. But you see, honestly, this is not the most powerful way to use Bollinger Bands. So I'm going to show you in a moment here the most powerful way how I have been using Bollinger Bands for many, many years. And when I'm using Bollinger Bands, how I still use them. So let me show you, because I want to actually go to the NASDAQ. And here you see, well, the NASDAQ is kind of a trending market. So let me show you how to use Bollinger Bands in the right way. You will see that often prices are touching the upper band. So when markets are trending, you will see that prices are touching the upper band. The question is, how exactly do you use them? If the market is in an uptrend, as it is right here, you will see that the upper Bollinger Band is turning up and prices are touching the upper Bollinger Bands. For how long? Until the upper Bollinger Band is turning around. So as you can see here, then you see here that it is turning around. Now also, in a downtrend, so take a look at the downtrend here, this is when you will see that the lower Bollinger Band is acting like a trend line below the prices. So whenever you see that the lower Bollinger Band is pointing down and prices are touching the lower Bollinger Band, this is when now the market is in a downtrend. For how long? Until when? Well, as soon as you can see that the Bollinger Band is flattening or turning around, this means that right now the downtrend is over. Well, let me give you another example. This is actually an example from PowerX Optimizer, a stock that I'm currently in. So I want to show you VSTO. I believe I entered VSTO yesterday. And you also see it here. See, Bollinger Bands at first are going sideways. And then when you see that the Bollinger Bands start pointing up and prices are touching the upper Bollinger Band, you see, you get the idea. You see that now the market is in uptrend. Now, how long is the market in an uptrend? Well, pay close attention here to the upper Bollinger Band. As soon as the upper Bollinger Band starts flattening or starts turning around, this is when the uptrend is over. So let's see. Just pay attention to the upper Bollinger Band right here. You see how right now the upper Bollinger Band is flattening? This means that right now the uptrend is over. Now, the question is, why do I not use the Bollinger Bands? Well, because I found that the three indicators that I'm currently using are absolutely perfect for this. So I'm using, as you know, the RSI, stochastics, and MACD. And if you want to learn more about how I'm using it, I'm posting a video. I believe it's called The Best Indicator for Trend Trading. And this is where I explain why I'm using this. And you see right here, as the market is going up in VSTO, we see green bars. And green bars are happening when the RSI is above 50, the stochastics is above 50, and the moving average is above. The MACD is above its moving average. And you also see right now here, can you see this? We have a black bar. And a black bar means that now the market is more likely to go sideways. And this is when the Bollinger Bands turn around. Now, let's take a look at this here. And let's see, when do we see that there is a downtrend going on? Right here, you see when we plot the red bars. And then we see the lower Bollinger Band. See, the lower Bollinger Band is turning around. It is pointing down right now. And we also see that prices are touching the lower Bollinger Band. Now, how long does this downtrend last? Very, very short. Right here, the lower Bollinger Band is flattening out. And this means that the downtrend is over. Now, right now, as you know, if you have the PowerX Optimizer, then you probably also entered VSTO, was it yesterday or 2 days ago? Probably on Monday. And you see, it gave us a perfect buy signal here, according to the PowerX strategy that you all know already. And you also see that the Bollinger Bands are confirming it. Right now, it's nicely pointing up. Prices are touching the upper Bollinger Band. Let me just give you a brief summary. If you need help identifying a trend, Bollinger Bands can help you a lot, because here's how it works. In an uptrend, the upper Bollinger Band will point up and prices will constantly touch the upper Bollinger Band. How long do you have an uptrend? As long as the Bollinger Band points up, once the Bollinger Band starts flattening, the upper one, the upper Bollinger Band, once this starts flattening, now most likely the uptrend is over. In a downtrend, you will pay attention to the lower Bollinger Band, and you will see that the lower Bollinger Band is pointing down and prices are constantly touching the lower Bollinger Band. How long do you have a downtrend? Well, as long as the lower Bollinger Band is pointing down. Once it starts flattening or even turning around, this means that the downtrend is over. I encourage you to play around with the Bollinger Bands, plot them on your chart, and you will see your favorite stocks in a much, much different light. Anyhow, does this help? Has this been helpful? If you enjoyed this video, please do me a favor and make sure to like it, because this way the YouTube algorithm is picking it up and showing it to more people. And also, if you want to see more videos like this, then click on the subscribe button and also click the little bell, because this way you get notified whenever I release a new video. Also, if you enjoyed this video, remember to share this video. Remember to share it in Facebook, by email, however you want to share it, and I will see you in the next video.